Hello, welcome to NRG Healthcare, a web page to discuss health related information. This is Dr. Akila. Today we will discuss about pre-diabetes. So what is pre-diabetes? So your sugar levels are not normal. At the same time, it's not too high enough to be called as diabetic. So when we ask patients whether you have a history of diabetes, they usually say the sugars were borderline. Okay, so that's correct. So it's in between the normal status and the diabetic status. So whether you will be having any symptoms during the pre-diabetic stage, usually there are no symptoms. We find out pre-diabetes during a routine health checkup or pre-operative health assessment. Occasionally patients do complain about thirst or tiredness, especially after taking food. So let's discuss what are the values for you to get diagnosed as pre-diabetes. So when you go for a fasting blood sugar test, if the blood sugar levels are more than 100 and less than 125, it is called impaired fasting blood sugar. This is one criteria. When you have food, usually gold standard is after giving 75 gram of glucose, they do the second hour blood sugar level. If that blood sugar is more than 140 and less than 199, it is called pre-diabetes. Coming to the 3-month average sugar, if it is more than 5.7 and less than 6.4, it is called pre-diabetes. So these are the values we look when we diagnose pre-diabetes. So whether the pre-diabetes is important, whether we have to take it seriously, yes, because there are chances for pre-diabetic patients to become diabetic. The chances are 25 to 50% in next 5 years time. Not only developing diabetes, if you are not bringing down your blood sugar level to normal level, there is a risk of cardiovascular disease in pre-diabetic patients also. So definitely the pre-diabetic status needs to be taken into account and appropriate measures to be taken to bring it down to normal. Because as I discussed before, it is a borderline report where you can act on it and bring it back to normal. So I want patients to ask few questions to themselves to assess the risk of pre-diabetes. Example, if there is a family history of diabetes, especially first degree relatives with diabetes, father, mother, siblings, there is an increased risk of diabetes. Similarly, age more than 45, but recently we do see patients with young age. And also, if there is any history of high blood pressure or cholesterol problem, we have to consider having blood sugar check. If it's a female patient, gestational diabetes, diabetes during pregnancy, after the delivery, they should consider pre-diabetic state, and also polycystic ovary, patients with obesity, or also the acanthosis nigrans is called. It's a blackish discoloration of the skin around the skin fold like neck or armpit. It shows insulin resistance, that insulin is not working properly. So these kind of patients needs to consider having blood sugar test. So if the blood sugar come back as pre-diabetic stage, what are the things we can do to reduce it back to normal level? First is lifestyle modification. It includes diet and exercise. So generally we advise patients who are smoking or taking alcohol to stop doing it. Coming to the diet, avoid fizzy drink, bottled juices, and extra sugar in the coffee and tea. Reduce the carbohydrate level and increase the protein level. We'll discuss in detail about the diet plan during subsequent sessions. Similarly, regular exercise, which includes at least 1/2 hour of exercise every day, minimum of 5 days in a week. So if we do all these measures, there is a possibility that we can reverse it back to normal. So pre-diabetes is important and it comes without major warning symptoms. And there are some risk factors which needs to be looked for. And it is a major risk factor for upcoming diabetic status and also cardiovascular disease. So please be aware of these symptoms and look for pre-diabetes. Thank you for watching.